So, well, I'm thrilled today. We've got a present. One of our viewers has sent us a present, this mysterious box. And check out the warning on the box. Warning: contains numbers. Exciting? I think so. So, shall we open up the box and see what this present is? We actually got two of these, one for Brady, one for me. We really appreciate that. Thank you very much for sending this. There we go. We have got some mysterious object here. Not sure what it is yet, Brady.
That's awesome.
What do you think? Yeah, what do you think it's going to be? Oh, we're going to have to plug it in. Now, I think you should. This one's yours, Brady. I think you should have the first press of the big red button.
I have no idea what's going to happen here.
Oh. Do I try it again? Now, have you worked out what it's doing yet? These are prime numbers. Each one is a new prime number. It's a prime number generator. This was made by our viewer, Karl Lautman, and he makes kinetic sculptures. So these are sculptures that move and do exciting things. And he's made, a short series of these, and he sent us a couple, and you'll get the next prime number. Oh, and it's so satisfying, especially if you like having a big red button to press. And it gives you a feeling of the gaps between the primes as well. You see, some are short. Oh, that was nice. That was satisfying. A nice long gap. It's really nice. I mean, it's a bit of silly fun. There's no practical use to it or anything, but I'd love it. Can't reset it, you're stuck now. You have to go through all the primes until you reach 999,999. Then it'll wrap back to zero. Now, we're about 251,000 here. Now, the prime number theorem, one of the big theorems in mathematics, says that the average gap between the primes should be round about the natural log of 251,000. I know that's about 12. So the average gap should be about 12. Some are going to be bigger than 12. Some are smaller. Sometimes you get a twin prime. And sometimes you get a long gap. But the really exciting number to wait for is 492,113. Because at 492,113, you get the longest prime gap that this machine can generate. It's a gap of 114. So I think that will be an exciting day when we can get to 492,113. So Karl's put in a microprocessor in this. I don't think it's doing anything clever. I think it counts the gaps between the primes. And he only has a few of these. Perhaps we can put a link to his website and he can tell people about his work. That would be nice. And but when they're gone, I'm afraid. It was such a surprise. I got a huge box delivered to my work, and I had no idea what it was. I wasn't told it was coming. So I had this huge box, and I was digging through all this packaging, and then this is what comes out the other side. And I plugged it in. It was given to me with a letter, so I did kind of know what it was. But it's the clicking noise. I mean, I was so thrilled. You do realise I had to pay the import tax for this.
Really?
Yeah, he paid me back. He paid me back.
Do you know what I really want? A twin prime. Give us a twin prime.
Of course, I'll do that for you.
Well, it won't be this. It could be this. No. Could be this. No.
What about a sexy prime?
Was that a twin prime?
I think that might have been a twin prime then.
Woo! Twin prime!
And it shows you, it does actually show you something about the randomness of the primes. They turn up frequently, but they're kind of unpredictable as well. Karl has very kindly signed it for us. He's dated it and he's numbered the primer. That's what he's called it. It's primer number 4. And I just showed this to Brady and he was very disappointed because he hasn't got a prime number. I got number 3. I got primer number 3.